Okay. It's nice to meet you there, here you're watching. My name is Anton. I'm going to give a talk on my library. This is written in Pascal. It allows you to write C sound in Pascal. Why does anyone need to write C sound in Pascal? We are going to see. The aim, number one of this talk is, how can you speed up your C sound creativity 100 times? Do you mean 100? Yes, I mean 100. And we are going to see it. I hope to convince you. The next aim is, I hope that after this talk, maybe some of you consider Pascal as number one language on your next, learn next programming language to do this. I want to start this talk with a demo. What can be achieved with this? I'm loading some Pascal code. Now I'm going to...
Can you make it larger? Is it possible to have it larger?
It's not.
The font.
The font.
The font.
So I'm loading some Pascal code. So I'm starting the main function. Under 100 of lines, you can write it yourself in 100 of lines. So if you like, in this part we are loading the samples here with bass, this bass drum I had. Then after loading, I've got some helper functions Drum 88, Drum 82, they rescale the samples to some to have the common BPM. Then columns rows of numbers on the keyboard, so they are aligned. Then it's some code. No need to understand it. It's just trickery to get it synchronized. And then main function runs everything. I've got parallel function that plays at the same time several lines, like in the track. I've got bass line, bass drum. I've got hi-hats and other stuff going. Actually, I've got one more thing. I don't have MIDI keyboard. Maybe I try it. It's not that good, but it shows the point. Maybe I try it different. I can change. DAC sends to speakers and VDAC sends it with virtual keyboard support. I don't know, the strange error is some 602. I cannot use virtual keyboard when GUI is running. Let's keep it. No, here's the code. Then let's go to the presentation. Here we go. Speed up. What do I mean by speed up? I want to speed up your sound creativity. It's not the first thing. It's not about performance. The sounds are actually very cool at performance. I've generated files of 3,000 lines of 5,000 lines of code, 10,000. It renders at the blink of an eye. It's really incredible. But the speed up that I'm going to talk about is syntax speed up. Syntax speed up is what do you going to write to get sound going? And it's really important thing because I think the sound is actually a little more behind than Python, Ruby, or Haskell in this aspect. And I choose Haskell because it's my favorite language to give the sound users the wings of the Haskell syntax to use it with the sound audio codes and sound engine. It's all about syntax. Sound expression is that is my library house code. It's Haskell program that generates the sound code. It's sound embedded in Haskell. What is Haskell? Haskell is the most widely used functional programming language. A functional programming language means it's more closer to the math. It can produce functions. Functions are values. You can take function, can take in function, can produce function. Is one strong point. Another strong point is static typing. It type checks your program. It doesn't blow up in the middle of performance. It's just before performance, and it shows you where your code is wrong. Actually, another strong point is active support of community. Actually, people who use Haskell, they love to use this language, and they're ready to show you what to do. I assume you don't know Haskell, of course. I'm going to show the strong points by examples. Let's start with the first one. A simple task. We want your sign going out of our speakers, and let's compare the solutions. Here's the sound one solution. It costs you 20 lines of code. You may say not so much, not so much. But for the novice, it's not really that obvious. What am I writing here? Why this XML is doing a lot of to explain for the novice. But when you move to the Haskell, how it is implemented, it's actually like this. Sound is general language. So the first line imports the library to some base. The next line is actually produces the sine wave. It's DAC, it's digital to analog converter, and it's oscillator. I decided to pick up naming conventions as an idea, and just that it shows that it works. I'm writing it right now. Wow. You might ask, wow, 12, I wrote 20 lines, because there are 12. I must be missing something. Something, yes, sure, you are missing. But I decided to put a lot of conventions for the users, for the novices that may start with something really quicker. We may say, wait, I want to set up the rates. Of course, you can do it. There is another function, DAC-by, that accepts as the first argument options, and you can set the rates also. You can set with options, you can set many, many things. It's just an example of how you can put your hands with globals that you really like to do in C-Sound. But how it's really possible. Another example, we move to the next. My friend gave me a wonderful synthesizer. I want to use it. I like to use it in my concert. But what should I do to just appreciate his efforts? In C-Sound, what should I do? In C-Sound is actually one file going, we don't have models. We need to Ctrl-V, Ctrl-C, this code, copy and paste. I don't know how many lines of code it adds, it's just how elaborate the code of my friend. But in Haskell we have actually models we can import. He can design a library, his library is, and import it is just a one line of code. Another example is standard waves. From this line we don't know where is triangle wave in this code, but here how is, you can write it in Haskell. I have put many efforts to give you standard tools to use. Another example, the lack. In some, I feel the lack of standard tools that, and timbres that you can use right away. For example, drum machine, how is it looks like in C-Sound? You don't know, maybe you can use some answer code, but in Haskell you can implement like this. There are handy functions. This is first line, we implement machine tier 808, and then we create some sound going. I can show you maybe how it works. Just an example. Actually, this more elaborate example. It uses VGCAD on notebook, VGCAD time to make it more flexible. But it's a single line of code to go. Another example is synthesizer. See some expression. There are plenty of synthesizers to use. Like maybe I show a little bit later how they sound. So there are many beautiful instruments, just 200 tools, you can use them and in your compositions. No need to write any code, just, and you can see the code, how they implement it. It's actually sound going inside. Another feature that I'm proud of is a UI code. It's all you need to write to implement sliders on top of that. Imagine we've got maybe not host square.
want to add a volume control of one of the things in function. Here's an outgoing. No need to. How is it implemented? We've got a lifter that applies a function to the output of UNOP. UNOP is unipolar knob, and it just multiplies the outside knob. It lifts the function to the UI control. It's as simple as it can be. We can actually add another UNOP. So we got two. We got two notes working. And just again, one line of code. A shift is just combines two sliders. Also, data collections. Also, we've got custom data types. Remember, you got to set up 20 or more parameters for granular synthesis. Now, in Haskell, there's implemented standard data type that wraps all auxiliary parameters, and there is default definition, and that we can use. And now it has just four parameters to go. Just you can use it like this. Also implemented as an example, granular delay. It expects a signal, not a table. You can just plug it in. Another example, custom data type is. Patch instrument data types may use as input not as values but also function. The first field is an instrument takes in note and produces signals. Also, another argument is chain of effects. They effect processors. They process signals. And what interesting, we can create functions that take in patches and produce patches. The function deep patch, for instance, it takes an instrument and adds another instrument on top of it that is an octave lower, and we get more deep bass. What interesting part of it that it creates, it accepts complicated structure and creates it again, and we can use it just like this. Another example is we don't need to create global variables to process effects because the functions that produce signals when you apply instruments to nodes, it produces a signal again. And we can just patch it into a code, just apply a code to it, and it's where it will go. If you forget everything, just two key ideas of my library. The first key idea is that everything is an expression. The thing is, when you build up a program, when in CSAMP you want to fit in different cells, this XML thing is for scores, this XML thing for instrument. But imagine that you can give a name to a bunch of nodes and another code takes it in and does something with it and produce another thing. And you can give it a name. Just a single variable. You can forget about the internals. So there is no need for instrument and scores barrier. When I implement the instrument to the scores, I give a signal. It produces a signal, and you use it and can use it again in another instrument. And then another instrument. Just goes on and on. Another thing is, actually it's the same idea, local is better than global. When you got this single value, it contains everything it needs to do to produce a sound. For example, when I show the knob, it contains not only the knob, But the algorithm it takes to produce the sound, when I add something on top of it, it already does it. And I can do a lot of things. I can just I can give to my users something, synthesizers that has actually knobs with it, and he can implant it in his own synthesizer. He don't need to know everything about wiring, global variables wiring. Everything is hidden in the simple name, and he can. For instance, this example is inspired by Ian Code. It's guitar processor. How many lines of code do you need to write that? Actually, I don't know how many lines. You don't know either. So I show. Here's the program actually. I have created the standard units. Why, if guitarists have standard units, why don't we have them? I have UI filter. UI filter is creates this little box. This little box with knobs. We've got UI cores. It creates UI cores. On the top are buttons that can stop or affect a path through. And here is all code to go. It's demonstration of the simple idea that you can go much higher if you have powerful tools of abstraction. We can just give it a name, another expression. Another example, granular core. Maybe I showed how it looks like. Here we define a simple function f at x that it takes in a scale parameter for the code. It takes in a pitch, and here we create a list of pitches, and we apply this function to all those pitches, and we create a sum. And mean is multiply and divide by the number of units in the list. And here we go. Oh my goodness.
Cannot find faults.
Can't find something. I can't find faults. Ah, okay. I'm sorry. Thanks for. Just two lines to go to create this structure. Maybe if you're a sound designer, you can go even further than me, because I'm not a sound designer, I'm just showing. The interesting thing that we give it a name to this expression, and it becomes a function. It takes in pitch, and run it the first parameter that I don't know. It just shows the idea. It's a grain rate, it's grain size, it's scaling by tempo, it's scaling by pitch, it's actual file to go, and here's the function. One double example at that time. Okay. This example just explains the idea of simple expressions. If I've got this expression that already implements a signal with two knobs to control amplitude and pitch, how can I add a switch to turn it on or to turn it off? I create another UI, it's toggle-sig, it creates a toggler button, and I can use this expression with multiplying by 0 or 1, so I stop or start. And this is how I can use already existing UIs just to import them and add my UIs on top of that. Actually, the whole thing is about to give the user as much as possible meaningful controllers. He to relieve it from all plumbing of creating integer names for functional tables or patching with global variables, the user should be considered only with things that means to the music he creates. Let's another example, how to play one file after another. We've got a function val, it just loads the file. We've got another function val, it loads another file. Function mel, it's melody. It stacks one limited signal by duration after another. And it's all code, you need to stack one file after another. Everything else goes under the hood. If we want to add a loop, we just add a loop here. Just the same expression. Thanks for giving me try. That's all I wanted to say about. Here is a project is hosted on GitHub. It's available with this package. Package is a standard distribution system for Pascal. Thank you.
So, any questions?
Yeah. Thanks, Sos. That was very impressive. My impression is that you have two sorts of wrappers. One is that you sort of translate or you reduce the C-sound opcode to a certain expression. And the other one is that you have different modules, for instance, this mel or loop, which are on top of things, more like
yes.
Syntax. Can you explain a little bit more? I mean, you probably have not translated all the 2000 opcodes, but only some of them.
It's actually almost all opcodes are implemented. I generate, Cezanne has one.
Already. Also, P also instead of also?
Austin, what?
Yes, I can explain it.
You come here.
I can explain it. There is. For instance, we have so many oscillators, that's mm-hmm. what I mean. But you have only OSC, it's only on top of OSC.
I've got. Cezanne has wonderful documentation. I've generated all the sound opcodes. Of course, they are available. You can use OSCIL I, OSCIL 1. One or still three, as you get used to it in C sound. But on top of it, I've added more simple functions to. I got a small core of simpler functions. I got LP for low pass, just to make it easier to type to get going.
It's you sort got of an alias actually, or it's sort of an alias.
Yeah, just
oh,
alias.
Okay.
OC is implemented as OSCIL three.
Okay.
With sign table. Another was question, and you got another function like mel par. There is a core Cezanne expression. It implements actually Cezanne, good and fast rendering of Cezanne code. And on top of it, I add there is a library Cezanne sampler. It adds some niceties to. Cezanne sampler is for signals that had duration. And if I know that Cezanne expression is for signal is infinite duration. Interesting part of it is that in DAC I send just a signal and it plays on and on. But with sampler I got duration, and if I have information about duration I can stack the segments, I get some interesting manipulation and another DAC BPM alignment. Another package is Cezanne Catalog. Cezanne Catalog implements standard instruments. Maybe I can I just want to show a couple of instruments, how they sound. Patch. I import the standard patches, and here's I can I use DAC is VDAC is for DAC is virtual MIDI. I don't have a device. If I had, I add MIDI.
Thank you.
I showed it before, I can... Sorry. I don't see it like you see it, because just by it was one example with my how to make it actually. And here I plug in the deep patch. It just processes this patch in adds more depth, lower nuance, solid. And you got a bunch of instruments just on the thanks for the sound catalog. I could have implemented by myself, I just implemented this is sound code.
Curious, like, where do you translate the Haskell functions into C sound string? I'm thinking about, like, could you do these expressions in another, like, in more programming languages? The method you use, I mean, where does the translation into the C sound string, where does it occur in your, how does it occur? I mean,
actually, it's just in the current directory where you own the program, it creates a file called temp.csd. And temp.csd contains C sound code. Here's C sound code for the microphone. And it just launches the C sound interpreter on it. Combine and it sends to speakers.
You can
use options to direct it to file to use your sound card actually.
But this compiler you make, it could be easily used for more programming languages, I would assume.
I think you can take the CSD file and just use it.
Yeah. I'm very interested, very cool.
One short question for you.
For signals that you want to split, so if you have an instrument and you want to go to a reverb and then a dry signal path and then come back to join, is it possible, like normally you think with like files or something, you would say you'd have your function and say width x equals or something so that you can share the value, you know, between the parts of the expression.
And the signal are actually, they're just a variable containing the signal. You give let x now goes to, and then you can use plus just like this.
Okay, so it's fine. You can just use let and that's fine too, then split the signal to another.
It's just a variable.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.